Fox 5 Health News and 54-year-old actress Bridget Nielsen says that she is getting ready to give birth to her fifth child. And while she is older than the average mom, experts say more and more women are getting pregnant much later on in life.
All right, joining us now is Dr. Suraj Sagar from Holy Name Medical Center in Teaneck, New Jersey. Thank you for bearing with me with that last name pronunciation there. All right, so what's the big picture here? Like, what type of pregnancy is this? There's a lot of questions, obviously.
So we have to put this in perspective. We know that pregnancy rates are decreasing in younger women, 20s, 30s, but actually in age 40 and above, it's increasing. And we've seen a lot of high-profile celebrity pregnancies, Janet Jackson, Halle Berry, for instance. But this is not just in the celebrity world. 2016 alone, over 750 women in the United States over the age of 50 gave birth. So this is very relevant in the general public as well.
Sure.
But we have to take some things in consideration, a little background. Fertility rates start dropping at the age of 32, by 37 more precipitously. So by the age of 50, only about 1% of women can actually get pregnant through natural means. So oftentimes these pregnancies involve reproductive assistance or IVF.
Right.
But having said that, you can have a safe, viable pregnancy if you keep some things in mind. The incidence of hypertension, high blood pressure, gestational diabetes, high blood sugar are all increased as we increase the age of the mother. So you have to keep this in mind. Remember, when you're pregnant, you have more blood pumping through the body, so you have to make sure the heart is healthy enough to sustain a viable pregnancy.
I mean, do we know, is this a natural conception? Is this, what do we know about
this? Well, I wouldn't garner, but if you look at statistics, there's a good chance that this was what we call assisted, whether it's IVF, frozen eggs, donor eggs. I wouldn't know for sure, but there's a more chance than not that it was.
And in all fairness to any woman out there who is, I'm glad that you said it's happening in regular life for
absolutely,
ordinary people,
absolutely.
But certainly the assistance, which is probably more common at this age, is very expensive, realistically.
It is expensive, right? And we have to realize there are health risks associated. They have to be under the guise of a maternal fetal medicine, a high-risk OBGYN. But otherwise, if they understand the risks and they are willing to take them, there's no reason they can't have successful pregnancy.
That's amazing.
Absolutely.
Really, really
absolutely.
Positive.
All right, how about this? What's the best shoe for your health? Experts say one that makes your feet do some work. All right, what do we mean by that?
Well, I tell you, I do a lot of running, and when I do these races, I do see people wearing sometimes barefoot or what we call minimal shoes. This is the older rage.
Yeah.
This basically mimics a barefoot.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
Why is this important? Well, we find that women, men and women who run or exercise and utilize this type of footwear have stronger, stiffer feet. Stronger, stiffer feet implies less flat feet. Why is this important? Flat feet is associated with things like cartilage damage, knee pain, low back pain. So a lot of interest in looking at, is this the type right type footwear to utilize? You know, we look at factors as the athlete's health. Are they diabetic? Are they running? Are they playing basketball? What's the conditions they're utilizing? What's their gait to try to gauge what type of footwear I recommend? And it can be confusing. So really, two key points. You want to minimize ill-fitting shoes, so too narrow, too short can cause things like calluses, bunions. And I'm sorry to say, but high heels are a problem.
We agree.
Yeah. Right. No,
I wouldn't know, but that's what I've heard. But in all seriousness, they do cause things like foot cramps, calf pain, knee pain.
It's an unnatural position.
Absolutely, especially those who are older or obese. It can cause a misalignment of the spine, lordosis. So keeping these things in mind, it doesn't mean you have to ditch your high heels, but you should utilize the proper shoe at the right time.
He looked right at you. Did you notice that?
I look fierce in a pair of high heels.
I mean, and considering the fact that I'm not even wearing high heels, maybe you are, because he looked at you.
Well, never mind. I have no comment.
Yes, me either. All right. We've lost the thread there somewhere, but we got the point.
We got
all right.
Point.
Make your feet do the work. There you go. All right, Dr. Suraj Sagar from Holy Name, we appreciate it. Thank you very much.